There are some of us that have been trusting God for so many things for so long. I bring you the good news. Your time has come.
Yeah.
I want you to talk to at least three persons beside and tell them, my time has come. My time has come. My time has come. What the youth church says, my time is
now.
I don't know when you want your own miracle, but my own miracle is
now.
Because it is written, the accepted time has come. You are not here by accident.
Yes.
I am not here by mistake.
Yes.
I want you to lift up your voice and tell the Almighty Father, I thank you for bringing me here today. I give you all the glory. I give you all honor. I give you all adoration. I bless you because you are my God. I bless you because there's no one like you. Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the Yahweh of Judah, the Lord of Shalom, Immortal, Invisible, the Only Wise God, Omnipotent, Omniscient, All Sufficient, Present Monster, the Root of Jesus, the One that owns the King of David, my God, my Lord, my King, my Maker, my Shield, my Shelter, my Banner, my Holy God, the same yesterday, today, and forever, the unchangeable changer, the immovable member, the immovable mover, the Lord of hosts, the Lord has never lost a war. You have never lost a battle. You are the King of glory. You are the Lord of my life, my confidence, my comforter, my companion, my everything, my helper, my healer, my hope, my joy, my source, my supply, the over El Shaddai, the over Nisi, the over Rapha, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the all of Jacob, my shepherd, my Lord and my Savior, God of Abraham, God of Elijah, God of Isaac, I worship you, I give you glory, I give you honor, for there is just no one like you, the God of the redeemed Christians of the cross, the God of Akira, the God of Fire, we worship you, we exalt you, you are worthy to be praised, we are worthy to be adored, you are worthy to be magnified, the unstoppable God, we worship you, we give you all the glory, we give you all honor, we give you all adoration. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you because you are the only God that can do what you are doing. We worship you, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name we worship.
Amen.
Still in the desert of worship, I want you to join me to sing this song and say, yes, you are the Lord.
Oh, sign. Yes, you are.
Oh, You are the most high. You are higher than the highest. You are taller than the tallest. You are bigger than the biggest. Your name is the awesome God. Your name is the great provider. You are the Lord that never puts hope in the shame. Wonderful. You are counselor. Mighty God. Everlasting Father. The Prince of Peace. We worship you. We adore you. We give you all the glory. Thank you, Jesus. For your name is worthy. In Jesus' mighty name. Almighty God, if all the ears on our head were to be dumb, they are not worthy enough to praise you. Thank you for your mercy that endures forever. Thank you for your mercy that are more than the sand by the seashore over us. Thank you for your church. Thank you for every life. Thank you for every family represented here. Father, today is your Thanksgiving. We dedicate this service unto you, Lord. Father, do what you alone can do.
Amen.
Father, Lord God Almighty, when Solomon kneeled before the people and said, Lord, this is your place. He prayed and said, Lord, when the people come and pray unto you in this place, answer him. Father, Lord, I decree, as I dedicate this place in the name of God the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost,
Amen.
I decree, Almighty God, that every prayer request that is brought to you in this place, you will answer by fire.
Amen.
Anyone that is under a curse coming to this place, then the curse shall be broken.
Amen.
Anyone that is struggling with one sickness or the other coming to this place, that they shall receive healing in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
In this place, O God, the jobless shall find job.
Yeah.
Those that are seeking for future partners shall receive it.
Yeah.
Father, in this place, there shall be financial breakthrough.
Yeah.
There shall be marital breakthrough.
Yeah.
There shall be health breakthrough.
Yeah.
There shall be breakthrough all around.
Yeah.
That in this place, O God, heavens will be opened.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Father, O God Almighty, when people are looking for solution everywhere, when they come here, Father, let the solution be given.
Amen.
We come in this building into your hand, O God. Every foundation that is not of you, we uproot them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We possess this land for Jesus.
Amen.
We possess this environment for Jesus.
Amen.
And we decree that it is well.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Almighty God. Father, we lift up your church into your hand that even at this tough time, O God, you will protect your church.
Amen.
You will protect your members.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There shall be no evil report.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Almighty God. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
If you're happy to be in the house, shout hallelujah. Take your seat. I want to talk to at least five persons and say to them, my time is now.
My time is now.
My time is now. Praise the Lord. Today, as we all know, is our first Friday service in this place. And this service is solely dedicated to the Almighty God. And by the special grace of God, this service is the Thanksgiving service. I don't know about you, but I'm prepared to praise the Almighty God. So I will not take more of your time. I'll just charge us for a few minutes so that we can have enough time to praise the Almighty God. Turn with me your Bibles to John chapter 14, verse 12. The book of John chapter 14, verse 12. It's a Bible verse that we are all familiar with. Are we all there? John chapter 14. Verse 12. The Bible says, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than this shall he do, because I go unto my Father. Quickly turn your Bible with me to the book of 2 Timothy. The book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2. And I will read verse 19 and 20. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19 and 20. The Bible says, nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, Having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his. And let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. But in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in our ears in Jesus' name. As we all know, this is the season of vessels unto honor. My prayer for every one of you is that the Lord God Almighty will make you a vessel unto honor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you take the story of Peter as a case study, the Almighty God prepared him a vessel unto honor, and the Lord made him a vessel unto honor. One thing you can see in the life of Peter was that when the Lord met with him in Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 7, God said to him, I will make you a vessel unto honor. You will become a fisher of men. But throughout the ministry of Jesus Christ, except for once or twice when the Lord sent them out, there was no sign that he would be a vessel unto honor. Because every time he just kept on falling and falling, he told Jesus in John chapter 16, he said, you will not go to the cross. Jesus Christ said, get thee behind me, Satan. After that, when Jesus left, he told the disciples, this Jesus, I don't know what is wrong with him. Come with me, let us go out fishing. But, unknown to him, God was preparing him. Maybe you are here that promises that has been given you long ago, and it looks to you as if the promises are not going to be fulfilled. I bring you a good news. Today is your time. Because that promises will begin to come to pass now.
Amen.
You know, when the time of Peter was fully come, the Bible says in Acts chapter 2, it says when the time was fully come, Peter preached one sermon and he won 3,000 souls. The next sermon, 5,000. The next sermon, the Bible says they were uncountable. And don't forget, the 3,000 are just men, excluding women and children. You can imagine, after waiting for so long, I know God made it clear to us in Joel chapter 2, if you read from verse 26 to 28, he says all the years that the locust and the cankerworm has eaten, he says, all I will bring to you in 1 month. I don't know what you have been suffering for. I don't know what level of loss you have experienced. God is here telling you. He says, this week, he will restore all to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are looking at the fact that this is the week and the month for vessels unto honor. God has made up his mind to restore. But he will only restore to vessels unto honor. Vessels unto honor are those that God says they will do greater things than what he will do. And many of us may be wondering, how can I do this thing? 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 8, it says, I have given you power. That the spirit that he gave to you is not any house, it's the spirit that gives you power. Now, when you have power, it depends on what you want to do with it. If you have power and you don't want to use it, it is up to you. But when you have power and you decide to use it for God, God will back you up. What he said is that, speak and I will confirm the word. But many of us, we want to prepare. What do I speak? How do I go? The Bible says either we live or we die, we live for Christ. So as a vessel unto honor, are you prepared to live for Christ? Are you prepared to be sold out to Christ? Because only the sold out will go far with God. You know, the Bible says, it says in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 1, it says, follow me as I follow Christ. In other words, it says, I will lead you
as Christ is leading me. So if you are sold out to Him, even at this season, the Almighty God will take you to your destiny. And He made it clear in Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. He says, the thoughts that I have towards you is of good and not of evil, to take you, this is my interpretation. He says, the Bible says to give you an expected end. But He's saying to take you to your destination. To your destination. But many Christians, many children of God are living without view, without plan. And the Bible says where there is no vision, the people perish. When the Lord was to make Abraham a father of nations, He said something to him. He said, Abraham, go as far as you can see. Let me tell you, what you will become is a function of what you can see. When I came to this country, I've always shared my testimony. 2 dirhams was too much to eat in a day. But I never see myself as a beggar. I knew what the word of God said. He said, I will be the head and not the tail. I remember those days when it was difficult to eat. Someone said in the group of Africans, he said, this tuber is too difficult. And I said, it's not difficult for me. And everybody looked at me and they laughed. Because they knew that I can't afford 2 dirhams to eat. And I said to them, you are looking at me now. I am going higher. You must be able to live and change your plan from grasshopper mentality. If your time has come, you can imagine if the Sheikh of Dubai just called you and said, I'm making you a crown prince. To be sincere, how many of you will change your walking steps? But if you know that you are a child of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, you should be able to walk with your head up every time, regardless of the situation you are in. The Bible says our living is not determined by the things of this world. That's why it says we are in this world, but we are not of this world. Your kingdom is of the heaven. You can't afford to live like people who are bothered by economy. I've heard Christians say things are difficult. Let me tell you, the Bible says, for with God, nothing shall be impossible. When you profess with your mouth and say things are difficult, it will be. You know why? Because the Bible says, in Numbers chapter 14, verse 28, it says, as you have said in my ears, so will I do unto you. And the Bible says there is power in your tongue. Many of you are where you are today because of what you have issued concerning yourself. You need to change. Let everything that comes out of you be positive. Why? Because in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. If you are in Christ, the only thing that will be inside of you is joy. When your joy is determined by the money in your pocket, you don't know Christ. Paul said, he said, though we die, yet we live. He says, though many people see us as suffering, but yet we give joy to others. That's why many of you, your situation remains the same. Where you are working, you are due for promotion. The promotion is not coming because your boss is looking at you and saying, this person does not have the charisma of a supervisor or a manager. But then I want you to know, the way you address yourself, that's the way you will be addressed. This is a new season. This is a time for best love to honor. You need to be a best love to honor, both in the physical and in the spiritual. And let me tell you, whatever we happen in the physical is first of all settled in the spiritual. If you are not a best love to honor in the hand of the Lord, nobody
He make you a vessel unto honor. And you see, vessel unto honor, they rule by decree. Example is David. David was a mighty vessel unto honor. Jesus was a mighty vessel unto honor. Peter was a mighty vessel unto honor. Paul was a mighty vessel unto honor. And they rule by decree. And I want to encourage you, brethren. Because the Bible says, greater is he inside of you than he that is in the world. I will give you an example and I will close. If you have 1 million in your account, you know you have paid all your bills, you have paid everything, you have even given out, and you still have 1 million dirham left. And somebody is just coming to you and start shouting and say, you are owing me 10,000 dirham, I will kill you today. What will you do? You can take, you snap him, you can stab him with 100,000 and then just get out from here, right? Now, when your father, the Almighty God, is the one that owns the silver and the gold, he says the heart is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, and all that are in them. Why are you bothered? Why are you troubling yourself? Because you don't have what to eat. When there's no food to eat, why don't you ask God? Maybe he wanted you to fast. Hey, I know some of us don't like that. But you see, because God knows what is coming in the front. I told you there was a time I can't afford 2 dirhams to eat. You know, in those days, fasting meant fasting. You know, I don't know if all of you understand what it means. Compulsively, you have to fast. And the day the 2 dirham surface, you will do 001. You know, all of that being like innocent now. Okay, don't worry. I thank God that God has elevated you beyond that. You will never go back there again. Yeah. You will never go back there again. But you see, at those times, I took time to learn what he wanted me to know. Because if I do not, I know I will never get back to that position. But I have the experience. I know what it takes when somebody says, I'm not eating for 2 days. But brethren, if you have to be a blessing to honor you, it means you be a source of blessing. The little God has given you, how many of it have been given out to others? Some of you say, my salary is not enough for me. And because of that, you can't even afford to give. Let me tell you, the only way to break through, the only way to financial break through is given. If you cannot give, you will remain on the same spot. Jesus Christ is willing to make you a vessel unto honor. You know, I found the Lord said something yesterday when he was preaching. He said, everybody is saying there's no money everywhere. He says that is not true. He said there is a lot of money everywhere. It's only that the money are in wrong hands. How many of you agree with me? And you agree with that, right? Money is available. If you don't believe, go to the gospel. Go and see what people are doing. If you don't believe it, go to the property sellers and see the way people buy 18 million houses just at the city. You know that there is money somewhere. But the money are in wrong hands. The Lord wants to move, wants to change that. But are you really ready for it? Verse 19 of that Bible says, let nevertheless the foundation of God stand sure. Let everyone that name the name of Christ, anyone that wants to be a vessel of honor, let them depart from iniquity. You know yourself. You know the things you do in the secret when no man is checking. But you've forgotten that the Spirit of God is checking. I want you to bow down your heads right now. If you are here, wake that brother up that is sleeping. Yes, he's waking, he's sleeping. This is not a time to speak. This is an awesome moment. I want you to encourage yourself. I want you to talk to the Almighty God and say, Father, please make me a vessel unto honor. Make me a vessel unto honor. Make me a vessel unto honor. And if you are here, and you know you have not been living right, or you have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and your Savior, I want you to just signify by raising up your hand, or you want to just reconcile back to Him and say, Lord, I'm here. I know I've missed it. I've gone astray. I've come far from you. If there's anyone, please just signify by raising up your hand above your head. The Almighty God is the one calling you. He said, I want to make you a vessel unto honor. Remember, He is the potter. You are the clay. He knows everything. And He can make you whatever He will. If you decide to deny Him, He says He will deny you before His Father. Jesus is calling you right now. If there's anyone in the house that wants to say, Lord, I am here for you. I want to come back to you. I want to accept you as my Lord and my Savior. Please signify by raising up your hand wherever you are. And the rest of us, I want us to talk to the Almighty and say, Father, anything in my life that will hinder you from using me, Father, destroy it. Uproot it now. Completely now. In the name of Jesus. Talk to the Almighty God. Tell Him, Lord, everything, anything in my life that will not allow you to use me, Father, uproot it completely, totally, permanently, in the name of Jesus, my Lord and my Savior, uproot them now, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. One more prayer for yourself. I want to talk to you and say, Father, make me a vessel unto honor, in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. Cry to the Most High God. Say, Father, make me a vessel unto honor, in the name of Jesus. My Lord and my Savior, make me a vessel unto honor, in the name of Jesus. Use me for your glory. Use me, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty. Talk to the Almighty and say, Father, make me your treasurer. Make me your divine treasurer, in the name of Jesus. I know you want to change the hands of money from the wrong hands. Father, make me your divine treasurer, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty God. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Our Father and our God, we thank you. We give you all the glory, and we give you all honor. We appreciate you, Lord, because there is none like you. And we say, be thou exalted in Jesus' name, Almighty God. As we continue in this service, Father, please continue with us. Accept us. Accept our thanksgiving. In this assembly, God, raise up vessels unto honor.